Columbus, Ohio. This city has grown by over 100,000 residents over the past decade and is a bigger city than you probably realize. They have a larger population than cities like Seattle and San Francisco. Columbus has outgrown their nicknames like Cowtown or the biggest small town in America. But these nicknames give insight on why so many have decided to call this city home. Now, it's your turn to discover what makes Columbus so special. Columbus is the most populated city in the state of Ohio and has now amassed around 900,000 residents. People are moving to Columbus mostly from within the state of Ohio, or they are leaving other Midwest cities with higher rates of violent crime. The median home price of $188,000 is enough to encourage many to move to this inexpensive city. While the median household income sits only at $53,000, this is actually still one of the most affordable markets for home ownership in all of America. So many people are willing to take lower wages in order to gain the ability to own a home. The average effective property tax rate in Columbus is over 2%, which places it 88% higher than the national average. The sales tax rate is only slightly higher than the nation's average at 7.5%. The income tax rate will fall approximately between 2.5% to just under 7.3%, depending on your income bracket. So, if you're a high earner and have an expensive home, you might get dinged a bit here. But really, it shouldn't be that much worse than many other places in the country. The violent crime rate in Columbus is 28% higher than the nation's average. However, this is actually one of the reasons people are moving here from other Midwestern areas. It is actually the safest large city in the Midwest. Now, the property crime rate is higher than I would like to see, but again, the Midwest, frankly, has a lot of towns that are more dangerous than anything you'll deal with in Columbus. I mean, you definitely take Columbus over places like Chicago, Detroit, Milwaukee, or Cleveland, where the violent crime rates can be double to triple that of Columbus. Now, that doesn't mean that Columbus has no crime concerns. You should absolutely be cognizant about where crime occurs here so you can make an informed decision. Now, Columbus is a college town, as many sports fans would know, and actually it's pretty diverse. But more on the college part later. The racial makeup of Columbus is just under 57% white, 6% Hispanic, just under 28% black, 5% Asian, 0.1% Native American, and 3.7% are two or more races. But Columbus is diverse in more than just the racial makeup, actually. They have a very diverse job market, where industries such as finance, education, healthcare, automotive, and an intriguing food scene are leading to many new residents. Ohio, and specifically Columbus, is known as a good city for many companies to test food concepts. The Midwest has a reputation for being friendly, and many people in Columbus are as nice as can be. Now, of course, not everyone is friendly in any place, so no need to type that out in the comment section. Well, unless you think I'm just way off base. So, you can expect a lot of unique options for many aspects of your life in Columbus. Now, the state of Ohio is an interesting place politically. They statistically, almost always, vote for whoever becomes president. The state voted twice for Bill Clinton, twice for George W. Bush, twice for Barack Obama, and twice for Donald Trump. Columbus itself is not that unpredictable. Joe Biden defeated Donald Trump by over 31% in Franklin County, and I really don't expect Columbus to vote red anytime soon. But the state itself, I'm really not sure what direction it will go from here. But as the saying goes, so goes Ohio, so goes the nation. The climate in Columbus is probably the second biggest negative to me. The annual days of sunshine are about a month less than the national average. You can expect 40 inches of rain and 22 inches of snow in the cold months. July highs are about 85 degrees, but don't make the mistake of assuming it'll feel pleasant. They do have some serious humidity here in Ohio, and the January lows average about 21 degrees. Now, if you dislike cold and snow and want sunshine throughout the year, you may be disappointed. But if you are someone who enjoys four seasons, Columbus does have a gorgeous autumn season, so it may not matter to you. They have been known to occasionally get a tornado here, but typically speaking, they really weren't too strong. As I mentioned previously, the food scene in Columbus is a significant part of the entertainment and experience here. Foodies enjoy sampling the great variety of cuisines that comes from a place as diverse as Columbus. The Columbus area has hundreds of parks, and perhaps the best one may just be Franklin Park, which leads you to the Franklin Conservatory. Right now, it looks like they're still open as well. Here in the city, they'll have everything you'd want in museums, nature trails, festivals, and art exhibits that you can explore. Columbusites, and for that matter, everyone in Ohio, enjoys cheering on their Ohio State Buckeyes, especially their football team. However, as a USC Trojans fan myself, I do have to deduct a couple merit points for living with so many Buckeye fans. Don't get me wrong, the people of Ohio are great. I just know too many Buckeye fans as it is. One of the best parts of Columbus is actually its proximity to so many great places like Chicago, Indianapolis, Louisville, Nashville, Pittsburgh, and Philly. You can day trip or take long weekends to some of these destinations and also travel within the state to Cleveland and Cincinnati. So, if travel is a priority to you, Columbus offers a great opportunity. Now, before I go into the next section, I just wanted to let you know that I have posted links in the description about Columbus for your research convenience. And if you got value from this, make sure to hit the thumbs up and subscribe for more videos just like this one. Columbus has some of the friendliest residents in America. They have a property and violent crime rate that is lower than other Midwest cities, but they're still higher than you'd like to see. They earn less than many others, but the cost of living is a whole lot less too. The property tax rates are obscenely high, but home prices are pretty reasonable. The climate gets cold and has less sun than most places, but they do have a gorgeous fall season. They are within a close proximity to many great cities, making it great for traveling and business opportunities. Ohio State offers a great higher education opportunity and provides lots of entertainment for the locals. So, I guess if the biggest con on my list is living by too many Buckeye fans, it says more about how nice a place like Columbus really is. Hey, click on one of those videos playing on the end cards for more great content. And if you have something to add, please do. Don't forget to subscribe, and until next time, take care.